Today we have discussed regarding about the logarithms. Logarithms is nothing but we have learned the definition which is belongs in the logarithm. That is logarithm. Where a comma nb a positive real number and a is not equal to 1 and a should be greater than 0. If x is a real number such that a power x is equal to n, then x is called the logarithm of n to the base a. It is divided by log n to the base a. That is 30. That indicates that if any exponent form number should be converted into logarithms, as a power x is equal to n, that implies x is equal to log n to the base a. In this one, we have to learn some of the points which is belongs in that. And those are the logarithm of non-positive real numbers can't be defined. That means that log of minus 8 to the base 2 is equal to x, then minus 8 is equal to the power of x. Here, if we can take any value of x, then LHS is not equal to RHS. For that only, the negative, the non-positive real numbers can't be defined in logarithms. The logarithm of same numbers, the different base are different. Let us take an example for that. Log. Here we have take the same numbers and we have take different bases. Log 16 to the base 2 and here log 16 to the base 4. Let us take that log 16 to the base 2 is equal to x. That implies 16 is equal to 2 to the power of x. In this form, it becomes into exponential form. For which value of x, if we can substitute for which value of x, LHS is equal to RHS, whenever x is equal to 4, then LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, x is equal to 4. Now you can take that log 16 to the base 4 is equal to y. Then 16 is equal to 4 to the power of y. Again, we got exponential form. So, for which value of y, then LHS is equal to RHS. Clearly, we know that if you can substitute the value of y is equal to 2, then LHS is equal to RHS. Here, y is equal to 2. So that here, the numbers are equal, but the bases are different. Then, it is, but both are not equal. The logarithm of 1 to any base is always equal to 0. Further, we can consider that, take an example, then log 1 to the base 2 is equal to x. That implies 1 is equal to 2 power x. Now for that, again we call what? We can get in exponential form. For which value of x, LHS is equal to RHS. When x is equal to 0, then LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, x is equal to 0. So that the logarithm of 1 to any base is always equal to 0. The next property is the logarithms of the different numbers to the same base are different. We have proved that again. Take an example for that. Log 8 to the base 2. Here, base should be equal. And log 16 to the base 2. Here, the logarithms are different numbers. Here, 8 and 16 are different numbers. And same base. Here, the bases are 2. But even though what we have to prove that is both are not equal. As let take log 8 to the base 2 is equal to x. That implies 8 is equal to 2 power x. But which value, again, we can get it in exponential form. But which value of x, LHS is equal to RHS? If we can substitute the value of x is equal to 3, then only LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, x is equal to 3. Similarly, take log 16 to the base 2 is equal to y. Then 16 is equal to 2 to the power of y. Again, we can get it in exponential form. For which value of y, if we can substitute which value of y, LHS is equal to RHS. If you can substitute the value of y is equal to 4, then only LHS is equal to RHS. Then y is equal to 4. Here, the logarithms of the different numbers. Here, both are different numbers and base are equal. But even though both are not equal. Now, we have to discuss regarding about loss of logarithms. Log mn to the base a is equal to log m to the base a plus log n to the base 8. Take an example further as log 15 to the base 2 is equals to, we can write this one, product of prime factors 3 to 5 to the base 2, which is equals to log 3 to the base 2 plus log 5 to the base 2. Log m by n to the base a is equals to log m to the base a minus log n to the base a. We have to take one example for this application, that is log 5 by 3 to the base 10 is equals to log 5 to the base 10 minus log 3 to the base 10. Here the value of m is 5, here the value of n is 3, and the value of a is 10. We can read this one as log 5 by 3 to the base 10. The formula is log m to the base a. Here the value of m is 5, alternatively we can write that as log 5 to the base 10. And here the value of n is 3, alternatively we can write this one as log 3 to the base 10. Now log m power n to the base a. How we can write this one? And log m base a, which is equals to, take an example further, log 1000 or log 1000 to the base 10 is equals to log n to the power of 3. How we can write 1000? 10 power 3 to the base 10, which is equals to 3 log 10 to the base 10. And we know that the value of log 10 to the base 10 is equals to 1. I will do that later. And next one is n to the base a power n is equals to 1 by n log n to the base a. We have to take one more example of this. Log 3 to the base 2 cube is equals to 1 by 3 log 3 to the base 2. Here the value of m is 3 and a power n is equals to 2 power 3. So we can write this one 3 as 1 by n. Further only here that the power of 2 power 3 should become as 1 by 3 into log 3 to the base 2. And last one, the log b to the power of m to the base a power n can write as m by n log b to the base a, which is because we have taken an example to that log 8 to the base 4 is equals to, we can write this one as log 2 cube to the base 2 square. So this is in the form of log b power n to the base a power n. Here the value of a and b are both are equal. Then 3 by 2 into log 2 to the base 2. Already we know that log value of log to the base 2 is equal to 1. We have to prove that again, okay? The logarithm of any number to the same base is always equals to 1. That is, what we have to show, that is log a to the base a is equals to 1. We have to prove this one, log a to the base a is equals to 1. Further, log a to the base a is equals to x. Then we should be converted to exponential form. A is equals to a power x. Here the base should be, again here the base comes into as base. Therefore, for which value of x? For which value of x? LH is equals to RHF. If x is equals to 1, then a is equals to a power 1. Therefore, a is equals to a. Therefore, the logarithm of any number, the logarithm of any number to the same base is always equals to 1. In the logarithms, we have to find the value of 2.3 whole power x is equals to 0.23 whole power y is equals to 1000, and we have to find the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y. For that, 2.3 whole to the power of x is equals to, at first we have to take 2.3 whole power x is equals to 1000. We can convert this one 2.3 as 23 by 10 whole power x is equals to, we can convert 1000 in exponential form as 10 cube. Now, taking power both sides 1 by x. Now, take covers both sides as 1 by x. That implies 23 by 10 whole power x to the power of 1 by x is equals to 10 to the power of 10 cube whole to the power of 1 by x. This is in the form of a power m whole power n. A power m whole power n, which is equals to a power m into n. That means that x into 1 by x should be cancelled. That implies 23 by 10 is equals to 10 to the power of, again this is out in the form of a power m whole power n. The value is, this is in the form of a power m whole power n is equals to a power m into n. That implies 2 to the power of 3 into 1 by x, that means 3 by x. That implies 23 is equals to 10 to the power of 3 by x into 10 to the power of 1. This is in the form of a power m into a power n. Since this is the form of a power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. That implies 23 is equals to 10 to the power of 3 by x plus 1. Take this one as first equation. Now, coming to 0.23 whole power y is equals to 1000. That he is given the data. Now, how we can write the 0.23 in fraction form? 23 by 100 whole power y is equals to, now this term should be written in the exponential form as 10 cube. Now again take 1 by y as over both sides. That implies 23 by 100 whole power y put to the power of 1 by y is equals to 10 cube put to the power of 1 by y. Here again this is in the form of a power n whole power n, that y and y should be cancelled. That implies 23 by 100 is equals to 10 to the power of 3 by y. That implies 23 is equals to 10 to the power of 3 by y into 10 square. Again, this is in the form of a power m into a power n. We know the value of, we know the formula of a power m into a power n is equals to a power m plus n, which is equals to 10 to the power of 3 by y plus 2. This is second equation. But it does have both sides are 23 indicates 10 to the power of 3 by x plus 1. Here also 23 indicates that 10 to the power of 3 by y plus 2. So both are equal. From 1 and 2, the value of 23 is equal to 23 indicates that 10 to the power of 3 by x plus 1. And here also 23 indicates that 10 to the power of 3 by y plus 2. Then both are equal. Therefore, from 1 and 2, n to the power of 3 by x plus 1 is equals to n to the power of 3 by y plus 2. Here the base are equal, so the power should be equal. That implies 3 by x plus 1 is equals to 3 by y plus 2. That implies 3 by x minus 3 by y is equals to 2 minus 1. That implies 3 by x minus 3 by y is equal to 1. Now take 3 as here. 3 is a common in numerator. So 3 is equal to 1 by x minus 1 by y is equal to 1. That implies 1 by x minus 1 by y is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, if 2.3 whole power x is equal to 0.23 whole power y is equal to 1000, then the value of 1 by x minus 1 by y is equals to 1 by 3.